He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Let's go through a practice problem regarding ionization energy. So the question is, place the following processes in order of increasing ionization energy. So the first process is IE1 for thallium, or the first ionization energy for thallium, meaning the energy associated with removing the first electron from neutral thallium. The next is IE1 for aluminum, so the first ionization energy for aluminum. Then IE3 for aluminum, or the third ionization energy for aluminum, meaning we've already removed one electron, we've removed a second electron, and now we're removing a third electron from aluminum. And IE2 for sodium, meaning the second ionization energy for sodium, meaning we've already removed one electron, and now we are removing the second. So if this seems confusing, go back and check out my tutorial on the periodic table and periodic trends, where we do talk about ionization energy and successive ionization energies. And when that all makes sense, give this one a try. So here are the transitions we are looking at, and let's find these elements on the periodic table, because this is a periodic trend that we're looking at. So here is thallium, number 81, here is aluminum, number 13, and here is sodium, number 11. Now let's compare these one pair at a time. First, let's look at these two, the first ionization energy of thallium and the first ionization energy of aluminum. So what can we say about these elements? They are in the same group, and thallium has many more shells. It has three more shells than aluminum does, so it's a much larger atom. Now, when we remove an electron from an atom, we are removing the electron from the outermost shell. We are removing a valence electron. And the farther away an electron is from the nucleus, the easier it is to remove. Because the farther away it is from the nucleus, the less electromagnetic attraction it feels to the nucleus, because that attraction drops off as the distance increases. So because thallium has more shells, the outermost electron in thallium is much farther away than the outermost electron in aluminum, and it is therefore much easier to remove. So the first ionization energy for thallium is much smaller than the first ionization energy for aluminum, because it is easier to remove that electron. We need less energy to do it. So we have first ionization energy of thallium as being less than the first ionization energy for aluminum. Now let's look at this second pair here, the first ionization energy of aluminum and the third ionization energy of aluminum. Well, let's be clear what we mean about each of these. The first ionization energy is when aluminum is ionized to become aluminum plus. The second ionization energy goes from aluminum plus to aluminum 2 plus, and the third goes from aluminum 2 plus to aluminum 3 plus. Now, for any element, each successive ionization energy is going to get greater, because as an atom becomes more and more positively charged, it's going to become increasingly difficult to remove negatively charged particles away from that atom, because it's going to continue to get more and more positive and more unstable. So that means that the first ionization energy for aluminum is less than the third ionization energy for aluminum, and that would be true for any element, because the ionization energies get increasingly larger as we remove more and more electrons. Lastly, let's look at the third ionization energy for aluminum versus the second ionization energy for sodium. Once again, the third ionization energy is aluminum 2 plus going to aluminum 3 plus, and that means we're going from a sodium electron configuration, right? If aluminum loses two electrons, go two elements to the left, we get to sodium. It will have 11 electrons. It will have sodium's electron configuration. And aluminum 3 plus is a neon electron configuration, which is a noble gas, and noble gas electron configurations are very favorable. So for aluminum 2 plus to go to aluminum 3 plus is not that bad because it's going towards a noble gas electron configuration. However, sodium's second ionization energy involves going from sodium plus to sodium 2 plus. Now, sodium plus is the neon electron configuration. That is very favorable. That's why sodium's first ionization energy is so low. It's very easy for sodium to lose one electron to attain neon electron configuration, because that is a noble gas electron configuration. However, the second ionization energy is going to be very large because that involves moving away from the very stable neon electron configuration to get to fluorine electron configuration. So we have the third ionization energy of aluminum, which highlights a relatively favorable process whereby aluminum 2 plus is becoming aluminum 3 plus and attains noble gas electron configuration, versus a very unfavorable situation, the second ionization energy of sodium, where it has to lose that favorable noble gas electron configuration. So definitely the second ionization energy for sodium is going to be much larger than the third ionization energy for aluminum. And so that is how that trend will finish up. And as it turns out, we had this already in the correct order. We have IE1 thallium being less than IE1 aluminum, being less than IE3 aluminum, being less than IE2 sodium. So that is the order for this trend.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.